Here in question number 6, a uniform solid sphere A rolling without slipping with velocity V naught hits head on an identical sphere B at rest. If coefficient of restitution is 1 by 2, then velocity of B when it starts pure rolling is. First, we'll try to solve the condition for collision, and then further, we'll try to evaluate how exactly the final velocity of B when it starts pure rolling. So, I will start with the conservation of linear momentum for the collision. Initial momentum was mv0, and let the final velocity of this part, it actually is v2, and this part is having v1 after collision. Then I would say it is mv1 plus mv2. We need to find the velocity v2, so I would say v0 minus v2 is equal to v1. This is our first equation. Another part is coefficient of restitution, that's been given as 1 by 2. The velocity of separation here, it is v2 minus v1 must be equal to coefficient of restitution into velocity of approach, that is v0 by 2. Or from this equation now, I would say v2 minus v0 by 2, that is equal to v1. Solving these two equations, I'm getting here as v0 minus v2 would be equal to v2 minus v0 by 2, or 3v0 by 2 is equal to 2v2, or v2 is equal to 3v0 by 4. This is the velocity after the collision. Now we'll try to solve what will be the final velocity once this sphere would start the pure rolling. For this, we'll try to solve the equation of conservation of angular momentum here. So initial angular momentum of this body will be, it is mass being m, velocity of this center was 3v0 by 4, and the distance from here it is r, and the final angular velocity, let's say it is omega, then moment of inertia about this point, it is 2 by 5 mr square, and plus mr square, it will be 7 by 5 mr square, and let the final velocity is v, then angular velocity would have been omega is equal to v by r. So this is the final velocity divided by r. So angular momentum will remain conserved. From here, this m will cancel out, r will cancel out, and I'm having v to be equal to 15 v naught divided by 28. So for question number 6, we are having option 4 as the correct answer. That means final velocity of this solid sphere B once it will start pure rolling, that will be how much? 15 v naught by 28. Now we shall proceed to question number 7. Here in question number 7, a uniform rod of mass capital M and length capital L is released from horizontal position. Find the hinge force exerted on rod when the rod becomes vertical. Well, definitely once it will be left from here, it will try to rotate along this direction and it will become vertical like this. And we need to find what will be the hinge reaction that will be exerted on the block at this instant. For this, first we'll try to solve the equation of conservation of mechanical energy. So for that, I'll try to find the moment of inertia of this rigid body about this axis. It will be, I will be taken as ml square by 12 plus m, this distance is l by 4, so it is l square divided by 16, or I is coming out to be 7 ml square divided by 48. Fine. Now from the equation of conservation of mechanical energy, let's say this configuration is taken as the zero gravitational potential energy. So initial energy would be how much? Zero. And the final energy, it would be minus capital Mg, this distance will be L by 4, plus 1 by 2, it is 7 ml square divided by 48 into omega square. So by solving this equation, we are getting the value of omega square to be equal to 24g by 7l. We'll try to write down the equation of dynamics here at this configuration. Just see on this side. this is the hinge point. It is rotating with angular velocity omega here. Force along the direction, let it is to be equal to F minus mg. It must be equal to m omega square into r. It is m omega square being how much? 24g by 7l into r. This distance is l by 4. So on calculation, we are getting this value to be equal to, so L will cancel out here. Here it is 6. So it is mg plus 6 mg by 7. So we are getting the value of F to be equal to 13 mg by 7. So for question number 7 here, we are getting option 2 as the correct answer. Now we shall proceed to the question number 8. Here in question number 8, in the arrangement shown, a solid cylinder of mass capital M and radius R is suspended by the help of an idle string and the lift is moving upward with acceleration G by 3. The tension in the string is. I will try to write down the free body diagram with respect to the lift. So with respect to the lift, the total effective force that will be acting, including the pseudo force, it will be how much? It is 4 mg by 3. And the tension will be acting along this direction. So that means with respect to lift, the torque about this point, it is 4 mg by 3 into r. And with respect to the lift, about this point, it will have the angular acceleration alpha. So I would write it down, alpha into moment of inertia. It is a solid cylindrical body of mass m. So it will be mr square by 2 about this point and plus mr square. So it is 3 mr square divided by 2. Fine. So m will cancel out. This r will cancel out. It will be 8g divided by 9r. That is the value of alpha here. Okay. With respect to the lift. Now I would say with respect to the lift, it will have the downward acceleration. That means A in downward direction, it will be alpha r. That will be 8g by 9. This is the acceleration of this cylinder in downward direction. But the lift itself is moving in upward direction with an acceleration g by 3. So I would say the net acceleration of the cylinder in downward direction, it would be 8g by 9 minus how much? It is g by 3 in downward direction effectively, and that is coming out to be 5g by 9. Now we shall write down the free body diagram in accordance with the situation we found here. So now I would say the total force in downward direction was mg, force in upward direction is t. It must be equal to m into a, m and a being how much? 5g by 9. So here it is 9 minus 5g, it will be how much? 4 mg divided by 9 will be the value of the tension here. Okay, so for question number 8, we are getting option 4 as the correct answer. Now we shall proceed to question number 9. Here in question number 9, two identical blocks are placed on the surface as shown in figure. What would be the minimum initial compression in a spring such that when the system is set free, the lower block jumps off from the surface? For the condition when it will be just able to jump off from the surface, I would say, let this was the natural length. So finally, it must extend by the value x so that the force exerted on this block, that will be how much? It will be k into x. It must be equal to mg, or x should be written down as mg by k. For this to happen, let's say it was initially compressed by x naught. So this was the initial compression I am saying. So by the conservation of mechanical energy, I would say initially this spring, it is having the potential energy which will now convert into the potential energy and the gravitational potential energy. So we'll try to solve the equation for the conservation of mechanical energy here. I'm taking this as the reference for the measurements of the gravitational potential energy. and the spring potential energy would be taken as zero when the spring would be in its natural length. So by considering these two statements, I would say initially the gravitational potential energy was zero, kinetic energy was zero, and the spring was having 1/2 kx0 squared. This is the spring potential energy initially. We need to find the value of x naught. Okay, now finally, by the time it will reach to this position, it will have the gravitational potential energy as mg x, and here this capital X, and plus spring potential energy as 1/2 k × x square, x square being mg by k whole square. So we'll be getting this equation as 1/2 kx0 square, mg x naught, it will be mg x naught, plus mg into x, it will be mg whole square divided by k, and here also mg whole square divided by 2k. Solving this equation for x naught, we'll be getting the value of x naught to be equal to 3 mg by k. Just solve this equation and we'll get this value. So for question number 9, I'm saying option 2 is the correct answer. Now we shall proceed to question number 10. In question number 10, two blocks are placed on a smooth surface and are connected through a spring or spring constant K. The two blocks are pulled away by applying a force F1 is equal to mg, here it is, and F2 is equal to 2mg along this direction as shown in figure. The maximum elongation produced in the spring is. What we shall do here, first we'll try to find out the value of acceleration of the center of mass itself. So it would be 2mg along this direction, 2mg minus mg, this is the total force, divided by total mass being 3m, so it is coming out to be g by 3. So once it will try to extend, it will reach a situation in which the extension will be such that every different masses here, this is m and 2m, they will have the same acceleration as the acceleration of center of mass itself. That means with respect to center of mass, that configuration will be taken as the most equilibrium state there. So from there itself, the maximum extension would be exactly twice of the extension that would have happened to reach that particular situation. That means first I'll try to calculate that particular situation where this mass shall have the acceleration exactly equal to g by 3. Let's say for that case, the spring force is Fs, and that is equal to k delta x naught. So I would say it is 2mg minus k delta x naught, and the mass is having the acceleration of how much? G by 3. So I would say it is mg by 3, and from here it is 2mg minus mg by 3, it is coming out to be 5mg by 3k is equal to delta x naught. So how much is the maximum extension? I just said that the maximum extension will be twice of this much of the part. That means delta x maximum will be 10mg divided by 3k. Fine. So for question number 10, I'm getting option 4 as the correct answer. Now we shall proceed to next question, that is question number 11.